Paying money for CD/USB boot disk from the IT shop may save you from downloading the ISO, burning into USBs, registering the product key. And the purchased medium can be used as a recovery disk for later rescue your computers/laptops. However, if you want to download Windows 10 ISO to upgrade the existing machine quickly, create unlimited backup installation drive, then I have 1001 ways to download the genuine OS of Microsoft. Make sure you can verify the ISO's file by yourself via their name or MD5 hashes to avoid incompatible/corrupted images. Unfortunately, you can't upgrade from Windows 7/8/8.1 and normal Windows 10 editions to Enterprise LTSC 2019. You need to install it fresh. You can only upgrade from Enterprise LTSB 2016 to Enterprise LTSC 2019 and keep your programs and files, reddit.com. At this point, the 1903 build is not ready to be deployed through Windows Update. You have to download it via MSDN channel. If you're Woo stuck, go with Woo Manager tool. In addition to that, Windows Insider program is a quicker solution to get the 1903 build. You should find it is not stable to be recommended for production environments. TechBench by WZT is a project that will help you without tedious search and registration to download Windows operating systems, Office applications, language packs, and virtual machines directly from Microsoft servers. Due to copyright issues as well as large volume demands, some high-speed download sources may not available as expected, like this TechBench by WZT. TechBench by WZT. Fortunately, we have another tool called UUP Generation Project. This tool will download the core OS with latest update /KBs, then build the final ISO image on the fly, so you can save time by not to install additional updates after the machine is set up with this tool. UUP Generation Project. For business /LTSC editions, Microsoft Evaluation Center is the tipping point, though these products, especially Windows LTSC, cannot be activated as usual after the 90 days trial period is expired. We need another tool called SVF-ISO converter to get the real production OS. Windows 10 Enterprise is designed to address the needs of large and mid-size organizations by providing IT professionals with advanced protection against modern security threats and more, Microsoft.com. Windows 7 and Windows 10 December refresh upwards use new download /decryption created by Mcuba50. New method directly uses encrypted /splitted ENS ISO uploads. Old method still uses the static links for the Enterprise Eval ISOs to download as source. Then downloads the SVF to create the ENS consumer or business ISO from it. When source was created properly, it will download the SVF for the chosen language and create the ISO. In case the source eval /consumer/business ISOs are present, the download is skipped. Just copy them to tools folder, gitlab.com. Attention! This tool requires a lot of computing process, bandwidth, experience from the user. So make sure you choose the guided option from README or Reddit articles. Carefully verify the generated ISO is not corrupted or contain bugs from Microsoft. In the past, I accidentally burn a buggy ISO of the 1809 build into my laptop. It ends up my machine constantly has high tilde 70% CPU usage. Apart from typical features like scanning, downloading, and installing updates, WU Manager currently packs in following new functionalities: ability to auto-download suskin2.cab for a Euro offline search of updates, ability to manually download found updates to disk. This is useful when Windows updates access to Microsoft servers is blocked. I choose to stay happy with the stable 1809 build, and of course, I will stick with the April update 1903 if it is official release through Windows Update or Microsoft download website. Do not forget WU Manager, it is an excellent alternative to WU. Tell me about your choice and experience with the new build, I will assist you if problems occur. 3.